Welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding its Sushasan versus development written by Vikas Pathak. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is very important for political science optional students. Now in order to understand this editorial, we need to understand the concept of development. Now as far as the concept of development is concerned, it is an idealistic concept. Now what is meant by an idealistic concept? An idealistic concept which seeks to establish egalitarian society. And on the other hand, we had various spin-offs, we have various diluted forms of development which is generally sold to the electorates under various ideologies to the people of the various constituencies of various countries. Now, what is meant by development in its ideal form? In its ideal form, development means there will be an holistic development. There will be an complete development. There will be a development that will be completely oriented towards homogeneity. Development which will be focusing on uniformity. Development in its ideal form wants to be manifested with the principle of equality and equity. Equality as well as equity. Now, development in the ideal form doesn't believe in the concept of caste. Development in an ideal form doesn't believe in the concept of competition. Development in an ideal concept, it believes in creating same level of welfare for everybody. So development in its ideal form, it is more close to the concept of socialism and communism. But development, when it gets associated with this capitalistic form or capitalistic ideology, it places itself on the agenda of competition. It doesn't believe in equality. It believes in market forces. The development here means the differential welfare for the haves and for the have-nots. Now, how the concept of development is being sold to the electorate of the Bihar? Now, the development for the electorates of the Bihar, it just means that it has to do something with caste. The electorate of Bihar is unaware, is lacking in the knowledge of the ideal concept of development. They're actually about a pole apart from the other end of the spectrum, which manifests, which tells of the idealness of development. Now these electorates, they believe that the development should be differential. Development should be differentiated. Development should be on the basis of caste. If our caste is doing good, this means it is development for them. And if other caste is doing well and they are not doing well, it is anti-development. So the development, the way it is projected in India, it creates a lot of fault lines. So we don't have a unified, we don't have a uniform, we don't have a homogeneous view about development. So the electorate's vision is quite myopic in India. And this is something that is manipulated, this is something that is maneuvered by the political class. Now this political class, they tend to exaggerate this view of the electorate. They tend to heighten this aspect of what the electorate is holding in their mind. Now the electorate believes that the caste-based development is the panacea. They believe that the caste has the most important element in it to unleash the development. They don't believe the secular version of the development. Now, what is the secular version of the development? The secular version of the development says that development can be done if we will develop industry, if we will develop agriculture, if we will develop education, if we will develop the health sector. They don't believe in this. They have a myopic view. The entire thing is viewed from the perspective and the well-being of the caste. Now, the development in India, it is more based on the concept of identity. And the electorates believe in cementing this identity. And the political class, the politician class also believes in cementing this identity thing. Because it makes easy for them to highlight, to advertise this aspect. They project themselves as the well-wishers of these identities that the people are representing. Now, why the people feel so much associated with the caste? Why the people are finding it difficult to feel associated with the secular development? The reason is the inertia, the social, cultural and the religious inertia which is holding the people back. Now, if the people will not be having this kind of inertia in their mind because of the predominance of the religion and the culture, then they will be able to vision the egalitarianism that can unfold only if they will be less and less biased. But the biasness of the electorate of the voters is cemented, is crystallized by the political class. And this is what is hampering the development of India. Now, if the selection and the election of the electorate will be decided on the basis of the fault lines, the development will be done on the basis of a fault line. Now, this becomes a kind of a to and a fro thing. And this is the big reason why we have been unable to move out of this conundrum from about 2000 plus years. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And you can also participate in the answer writing program that we have started on brainiki.com. You can visit the website for the various details. And you can also visit our websites to view the information of the classes that we are offering. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.